The Secret River by Marjorie Kinnan Rawlings. There is a dark green forest far away in Florida. The trees are so tall that the sky is like a blue veil over their leafy hair. Vines with red and yellow flowers grow up the trees. Red and blue and white gray birds have their nests in the branches. Squirrels scamper up and down the trunks and bury their acorns and their hickory nuts among the roots. At night, when there is no one but the owls to see, small animals with soft fur and bright eyes run and play and hunt for their supper. There is a path through the forest. It leads to the home of Calpurnia and Buggy Horse. Calpurnia is a little girl, and Buggy Horse is her dog. Her name is Calpurnia because she was born to be a poet. Buggy Horse is a peculiar name, but even when he was a puppy, his back dipped in the middle, and he had an enormously fat stomach, just like a little old buggy horse. He could not possibly have been called Rex or Rover or any ordinary name for a dog. Calpurnia wrote her first poem about him. "My dog's name is Buggy Horse, of course." On the morning when this story begins, Calpurnia was awakened very early. Outside her window, two redbirds were singing to each other. They sang so loud that she heard them in her sleep, and she woke up. She listened, and she decided that one redbird was singing, "Love me, love me, love me," and the other redbird was singing, "Sure do, sure do, sure do, ooh." The redbirds flew away together to build a nest. Calpurnia looked over the side of her bed. Buggy Horse was still sound asleep on his own hooked rug beside her bed. She said to him, "Wake up, my dear dog. I have a feeling something special is going to happen today." Buggy Horse just stretched himself and yawned. He was a lazy dog. He liked to sleep for hours, sometimes in the sunshine and sometimes in the shade. He hoped Calpurnia was not getting ready for an adventure. He was obliged to follow her wherever she went, because he was miserable when she was out of his sight. Calpurnia washed her face and hands and brushed her teeth and combed her hair. Because of her feeling, she put on her best pink hair ribbons. She made her bed neatly. Her room was so clean and tidy, the company could have come at any moment. She went out of doors with Buggy Horse and saw that it was indeed a beautiful day. The sun was shining and the oranges on the trees were as bright as balls of gold. She said a poem. "Lovely day, come what may. If I did not love my mother and my father, I would run away, because it is a running away kind of day." As it turned out, she had the best reason in the world for making a journey. Her mother called, "You two little hungry things, come and get your breakfast." At breakfast, Calpurnia's father said, "Hard times have come to the forest." She said, "What are hard times?" "It means that everything is hard, and especially for poor people." She felt of the table. She laid her hand on Buggy Horse's back. She ate another mouthful of grits. And it was true. Everything seemed harder than usual. She asked, "Are we poor people?"